Hey, Steven here with Cash Grow Cook, and today we're going to go over what plants you can grow hydroponically and which plants you cannot or should not grow hydroponically. Now, I'm just getting started growing plants hydroponically, and this took a lot of research to figure out what you can and cannot grow, but really it's probably what you should and should not grow hydroponically. So let's get into it. Now, I put together a helpful guide on what plants do well in a hydroponic setup. So click on the link in the video description down below and it'll take you to a page where you can quickly see what plants are commonly used in these hydroponic systems, as well as I'll put some plants that typically do not do as well. Now, the rest of this video, we're gonna go over just some examples of why certain plants are well suited for hydroponics and why others don't do as well. Because that way, when you understand some of the characteristics of these plants, you can see if there is a plant that's not on the list in the video description, whether or not it is worth trying with a hydroponic setup. So hopefully it helps, and with that, let's get to the rest of the video. So let's start with some plants that you should not grow hydroponically. Now behind me, I have some beautiful corn that is getting quite tall. These are probably about 2 feet tall. And you can see that it has a big planter. This is probably 2 feet by 2 feet. So as you can imagine, corn just takes up a lot of space. So it takes up a lot of vertical space, which means that for hydroponics, you would have to provide a lot of vertical space. So this is the reason why corn is a plant that is not recommended for hydroponics. Now, can you grow it hydroponically? You should be able to, you can, right? As long as you provide it nutrients, you give it the right amount of sunlight, and it has enough room to grow, it can. But should you? Probably not. There's probably better plants that you could plant that would utilize the space more efficiently than a corn plant. Now behind me, we have my favorite bush up here in Oregon, and my favorite one that's in our garden, which is a blueberry bush. These produce a lot of delicious blueberries that I absolutely love to pick and eat, but this plant is about as tall as I am, if I actually stand up, which is 5'10", and it's probably about 3 or 4 feet wide. So realistically, to grow this hydroponically would be a challenge because it's just so large, right? Now, I've seen that people can grow blueberries hydroponically by using the dwarf varieties. So once again, you just have to be really careful about the plants that you choose when you grow things hydroponically. And really the only reason why this plant would not be good, or this particular species of blueberry, is that it's just too big, right? So once again, space is really the only reason why this blueberry bush is not a good plant to grow hydroponically. Now the last plant type that I could think of that is not a good hydroponic plant are ones that are like this grape. They're viney, right? So behind me, it's growing right next to a fence, and that's just so it can cling onto this fence as it grows up and produces grapes. Now, once again, due to space, and really when you're growing in a hydroponic system, you're trying to have it self-enclosed and potentially mobile, you don't want a viney plant because then you'd have to build some sort of trellis, right? And once again, it just takes up a lot of space. All right, when you think back to all the examples you just saw of plants that you should not grow hydroponically, right? We have the corn, which was too tall. You had the blueberry bush, which was too tall and too wide. And then I also showed you a viney plant. Now, in all those examples, these are just big plants, right? Now, you can grow them hydroponically, but should you? Probably not. When you can take that same space, take that same amount of nutrients, and grow a lot of these next few plants that I'll show you, it just makes more sense to grow the plants that have shorter harvest cycles and that grow a lot faster and smaller, so that way you can utilize the space better. And if you look behind me, I chose this spot because it has a beautiful maple tree, which once again, theoretically, you could grow hydroponically, but these obviously take years to grow. I can't imagine the years of maintenance to grow a maple tree hydroponically. And I actually am curious, but I would be reluctant to see how much water and nutrients this tree takes every single day. So once again, can you? Yes. Should you? Probably not. Now, here's an example of a plant that is great for hydroponics. And this is really just a strawberry plant. Now, I have a bit of a little ceramic strawberry tower here that's full of soil, but you can absolutely make this exact same thing and grow strawberries very well in hydroponics. Once again, you can see strawberry plants. They are bushy, but they are tiny, right? So it might only be a foot wide and who knows, maybe half a foot tall. So that's just a really small, compact plant that once it starts fruiting, you can just pick off those strawberries, and if it's evergreen or ever blooming, you'll just keep getting more strawberries as your hydroponic system keeps feeding it. So once again, this is an example of a good hydroponics plant. Another example of a great hydroponics plant are these cherry tomatoes. Now you can grow a lot of different type of tomato plants. Once again, these are viney, but there are the more dwarf variety or the ones that tend to stay at a smaller size. So that way, hydroponically, they won't take up as much space. So once again, tomatoes, you can do them, but look for the smaller or dwarf variety type tomato plants. And these are very popular hydroponic plants since. Now another example of a good hydroponic plant are herbs. So behind me I have basil, but you can grow thyme and any other type of herb that have a short grow cycle and that are relatively small. So once again, that's really it in terms of the criteria for what makes a good hydroponic plant versus a not so great hydroponic plant. I'll leave a link down below so you can see more, or you can see a full list of plants that are good hydroponic plants and ones that are not. And yeah, feel free to comment down below if you have any questions, whether or not you should or should not grow a plant hydroponically. But hopefully this helped. This is where I'm going on my hydroponic plant journey or hydroponic growing journey. And I hope to see you on it as well so we can all enjoy fresh vegetables and herbs throughout the year and through all the various seasons, regardless of what the great outdoors have for us. So with that, I'll let y'all go and happy gardening.